Hi everybody, my name is Gus Posey. I'm the STEAM lead here at Wings Over the Rockies Air and Space Museum. Today I'm going to show you a fun paper airplane that's something I've been working on for a number of years. This is our Boomerang plane, and this of course is a plane that comes back to you. Now there are a lot of advantages to that, but also a few tips and tricks that we might want to use to make sure that happens. So as we go through the folding process today, I'm going to be using kind of a basic 8.5 by 11 sheet. I've also got a ruler just so I can make sure I have some careful measurements and a pair of scissors. As per usual, I've also got my cylinder-shaped marker here. It makes a nice flattening tool for my folds. So as we're going through there, we can get a nice crisp edge on all the wings. Now, as I begin this process, I am gonna turn the paper over. Once again, I'm gonna keep the wings logo here as part of my design. So I'm gonna put that face down towards me so that when I'm done folding, that'll appear on the wing. If you have a similar design, I recommend putting that one down there as well. Now to start, we'll start, as we so often do, with the world famous hot dog bun fold. Once again, just going right down the middle, matching the corners, and trying to make sure that's as symmetrical as possible. It doesn't have to be perfect, but as close as we can get will definitely be helpful to us. And just as we did with the Nakamura, I'm gonna crack this open and come up here to the top edge in the corner, fold that right onto that center line. Center line's really valuable. It's a good reference, helps make sure that we have the same distance on both sides, and also just a good guide for some of our future folds. You might notice here that I'm making sure those triangles are right next to that center line. There is no space. On the next fold, however, I'm going to take this edge right here, kind of pinching or curling and rolling it over towards that center line, but this time I'm leaving just a little offset here, maybe just a couple millimeters, maybe as much as a quarter inch there, but not much more than that. But I'm not touching the center line. There's just a bit of space there. Of course, whatever space you generate on that side, we want to generate on this side as well. So when I fold over here, I'm just matching that, trying to make a nice mirror image so they're the same on both sides. Now right now we have a very traditional paper airplane shape, something you've probably seen before, and this is where it gets a little bit crazy. We're going to come up here to the point of the triangle and fold it straight down onto the center line about an inch from the bottom, again about 2.5 centimeters from that bottom edge. Now you may have, as I do right now, a little problem here of a bulging wing on this side and a little bit of a bulging wing on this side. That's what the marker's for. So right here in the center line, if I press down here and just slide out to the edge, even if it gives me a new corner, that's fine. I just want a nice sharp crease along that wing to make sure that that's flat and symmetrical. Now once you have this shape, we come back to the point of the triangle. This folds straight up this way. And what I'd like to try to do here is I'm folding it at about the third mark in the hopes that when I'm done folding, I have about half of the triangle above the line and about half below the line. So it's divided about half and half by its height, not its area. That's a triangle joke for those of you who are watching. Now once I have a shape like this, I can continue folding, making sure this is in the middle. I can use this line on the back to gauge that, make sure it's all nice and straight, again, nice and symmetrical. And then I'll pick up this whole thing and fold it all in half with our folded edges on the outside. Once again, this is a chance to make sure things are symmetrical, the corners are matching, and everything's nice and flat. Now, as we sometimes do, we have reached the tricky step. If you have a shape like this, you're gonna grab a ruler, and we need to make one measurement. A lot of aircraft, including this one, use angle of attack to deflect some air downwards to help produce some extra lift. To do that, we need a special angle on the wing to make sure that we're sending the air the right direction to send the rest of the plane upward. So on my ruler here, I'm going to measure in centimeters today, but from the bottom here, I've got 1, 2, 3 centimeters, and maybe my flattening tool can be used for a second purpose here just to mark that off. Now once I've got that, I'm going to use 3 centimeters as a special mark to say that's where my wing will be folded, and it makes a line. It goes from 3 centimeters here, all the way back to here, right where this vertical line meets this diagonal line. So we're going to join this dot with our fold. Now this is what that looks like. I'll take my ruler, put it right below the dot here, right below the dot here, and then I'm just going to fold the wing right down the edge of that ruler, nice and flat. I hope you can see that this is not a straight line, it's diagonal. It's a little bit small in front and then gets a little bit bigger coming towards the back. Again, this is about 2 centimeters. This back here is about 3 centimeters. Now once I have the first wing folded, I'm just gonna flip that over, fold the other wing to match. Again, being a little bit careful to make sure they're symmetrical. And we'll get that folded all the way back to the back of the plane. With the wings together, I'm coming out here to the wingtip to add a winglet, a small vertical surface. So I'm folding that back towards the body, about a centimeter, about as thick as a pencil. Now I do that with the wings together so I can fold one, flip it over, and then I fold the other one to match. Once I've got those folded, I'll raise the wing. Again, a little dihedral, never hurts. A little bit of that Y shape. And I'll raise the winglets out and away from the wing. Now we're almost done, but we have a couple more steps just to make sure this is a good plane, but also a plane that will come back to us as a boomerang should. Need some scissors. We're gonna come down here to the bottom of the plane, and if you can imagine a rocket, flat on the bottom, pointy on the top, we're coming from the bottom. So the scissors come up about an inch, so again, about 2.5 centimeters, and then I turn them towards the nose, about 45 degrees, and cut all the way to the crease. What's important is I'm not cutting past the crease. I don't want to cut the wing, I just want to cut a piece of the body here. Once that's cut, I can open this and take the part that I cut from the bottom straight up to the top. Now, having done that, this line and this line are now backwards, so I'll push those together in the middle, to the side, and to the other side on the crease. The shape I'm looking for here is a diamond. So when you're up and flying, you have a nice diamond-shaped tail. Now we're almost done. For the final fold, I'm going, coming back to the triangle of the nose. I'm just going to fold this in half, so right in the middle, bringing the point of the nose inside the plane, just a bit, and then I'll fold this closed, squeezing this tightly to make sure I've got a nice strong nose there that won't compress and collapse all the time. Now, we've done all the folding we need for the boomerang. We're gonna do one thing just to adjust for making sure that it wants to come back. If I pinch the plane right in the middle, I'm going to take the tail and bring it straight forward to my fingertips on the other side, just like this. And then I'll let it pop loose, just like that, just to add a little bit of curve to the back of the wing. So having completed our final fold, we can make a few adjustments here, possibly to the winglets, and once I get out in the hangar, I'll show you a little bit more about how to adjust that for your boomerang flight. All right, everyone, hopefully you had a chance to fold your boomerang and now have some chance to test it. I'm out here in our hangar with lots of room to fly. I'm gonna hold the plane right up here where the paper is thickest. I'm gonna make sure that the wings are up just a little. That dihedral is always important. And just to cheat a little bit, I've got my left winglet all the way straight up. My right winglet is coming out here just a little bit. I'm gonna aim up, a little bit of extra energy, and it should come right back. Thanks for watching, and see you next time for more tutorials.
Thanks very much for watching. You know, we've got a lot of really great artifacts in this museum, and we can hardly wait until the time comes when we can open our doors again and you can come and see them in person. Until that time, we're going to be working very hard to bring you new content, new demonstrations, new workshops, all kinds of wonderful things for you to watch on video. We're really dedicated to our mission of educating and inspiring people of all ages about the aerospace endeavors of the past, present, and future. If you like what you've been seeing, and if you want to support our museum, please follow the link below and make a donation. And thank you. Thank you very much.